Will you please welcome Mr. Steve Bailey and Mississippi McDonald in the house? Seattle, they're lucky to have a clean t-shirt on.
Let me introduce this fabulous band. That's Mr. Phil Deering on the Gibson 335. Mr. Elliot James Badger, we call him the Fonz. Mark Johnson Brown on the drums, ladies and gentlemen. Mark Johnson Brown. Washington State Blues Society Hall of Famer and a dear friend of mine, Mr. Steve Bailey.
Yeah. Some of the Sonny Boy stuff in the second set. We have a brand new CD that we just finished, produced by Mr. Phil Deering over here. And I got the inspiration to do it last year when I was over here. We started talking about every blues man you meet in the States has a Sonny Boy stories. We started talking about the London Sonny Boy stories when over here, and kind of got the idea London still likes Sonny Boy. So we did a brand new CD we got for sale tonight.
Bye. ask you to love me. You said no from fear of mine. Good thing, be a bad.
Fixer's record, which we did, we on Radio 2 in 2016, man. Yeah, 30 years of trying with this perseverance.
Yeah.
take it off, man. You can't take it off.
We already did dress for the money, so.
Money, we got four shows in a row, so maybe you do want to take it off. It's going to be rough.
I heard that a lot of my life. Don't take it off. Don't take it off.
Thank you so much. It's a real pleasure. Thank you, Mr. Dunning, for having us back here. Do you know what? We see some familiar faces and some lovely friends and people who've supported us and me and the band through all the years. So I want to say thank you so much to you. So kind. Thank you.
Louisiana right there.
I'm so lucky. I've been to the US a few times, and as a Brit guitar player, your dream is to go play with a band in the US. And I met you, Steve, in Seattle, Washington, and you let me come and play with you three or four times, and I'm honored about that, man. I'm also honored to spend time with you.
Too bad the last time I was playing at a Chinese restaurant.
It was.
Yeah,
that's
okay.
I wasn't that hungry.
It was a nice crowd at the Chinese restaurant.
But I get to travel with Steve. I get, he hangs out in my house and generally entertains my kids.
I brought him Dr. Seuss books. You guys had, you know, Shakespeare and Dickens and stuff, and we have Dr. Seuss. So I brought that on.
It reminds me of that LA story thing. Some of these buildings are 20 years old.
Yeah.
But Steve tells me these great stories, and of my heroes, our heroes, of Albert Collins, who you played with and you hung out with, and. Tell them about when John Lee Hooker stayed at your house.
Which part?
When you cooked dinner for him.
Oh, well, yeah, but he didn't want to eat the dinner. We went out to a place, and it's a house of pancakes, and they have almost nothing but pancakes. And so I didn't realize John Lee couldn't read and write. He went out there, and we all trying to decide what we want, looking at the menu, and it's all just writing on a piece of paper. And he generally goes, "You got any pancakes?" So we didn't want really. We ended up going to. He wanted to go to Denny's. I don't know if you've ever been to Denny's in the States, but it's a picture menu, so he could say, "I want that," you know. But here's a man with 100 albums. That is an incredible person, though. Really, really great guy. Yeah, and he stutters like crazy, but not when he sings. He's a really, really great guy, though, John Lee Hooker.
I have to ask him that every time I see him. So I've heard that 12 times, and it's still cool.
Yes, you call me Mississippi.
was the only person who'd ever been there. I was the only person who could spell it first time.
Country, and the guy was telling us they used to have they were short on the rent, they had a house party barbecue, and everybody come over and help them with the rent. It doesn't work anymore, but that's what I finished the rest of the song for him.
House party barbecue. A one, two, three.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Elliot James Bowden. The funk. And this wonderful drummer, ladies and gentlemen, this is Mr. Mark Johnson Brown. My musical partner in crime, fantastic producer, all-round musician, and dear friend of mine, that's Mr. Phil Deering on the three. We call him the tallest working man in show business.
Aren't you gonna do the, you've been to college, aren't you gonna do the mathematical verse? I'm 3 times 7, that makes 21.
To take off all my clothes, jump in the ocean, but it ain't, it ain't. Ain't nobody's business what I do, yes, what I do.
We got one more for you, and then we're gonna go to the bar, and we're gonna introduce Steve Bailey to the delights of British cuisine. And I've seen some pork scratchings.
Oh man, he's in for a treat.
They don't have that haggis here. That's not the right place for that, is it? Bring out any of that haggis stuff.
It's not just
different country, right?
It's not just mashed potatoes.
No organ meats, right? Mississippi McDonald, that's Ollie. Yeah. Right there. How about Ollie? Yeah. And if you decide to go to the ocean and take off your clothes, let me know so I'm not coming. I won't be there. And it won't be my business if I'm there. See? This tune's by the great A.C. Reed. I saw him when he was in town with Buddy Guy, back before Buddy Guy just started fooling around but actually played. And A.C. Reed was a really, really great. Check him out on YouTube. He's got some great songs. He's got one called Mean Cop Blues that's funny. And this one I've always liked, and one tune I've hung on to for many years. This one's called Talk About My Friends.
One, two,
I've got lots of money, but I've got lots of phony friends. Thank you.
Money gets some folks hurt. Money gets some folks killed. It's a dude. I can't trust nobody. Not even my buddy, buddy friends. Well, now they're stabbing in the back. They're trying to mess with my baby.
is a leg. Oh, is a leg, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, is a leg in the devil's chain.
Now we're gonna do. I just moved up here. It sounds so much better. I couldn't hear myself, and now I should have moved right away. Anyway, this is one of the Sonny Boy tunes that we recorded on the new CD. It's a little thing, another little intellectual masterpiece here by Sonny Boy. Too Young to Die.
Barrel of a 38. scared of that shot. I'm scared of that shot. But I'm scared of that shot, 'cause I'm too young to die.
So, Ollie, what was the name of the hotel that Sonny Boy stayed in here in London, do you know?
We had a competition on Saturday night, which nobody won, right?
Oh, okay.
It was the hotel that is by Piccadilly Circus, the one that had loads and loads of rooms in it, by the other...
Anyway.
Yeah. Anyone knows that without Googling, because that's cheating, my friends. We'll give you a record.
Sonny Boy, when he traveled, he would he'd take a coffee can... Coffee can and a bag of beans and Sterno and cook in his room. Even though he's staying at the best hotel in London, he's cooking his room. So they came up to his room and they go, Mr. Williamson, you can't cook in your room. You know, being very polite. He goes, sure I can. Pulled out a big knife. And the guy went downstairs and he got the hotel detective. So here comes the detective with a nice tie on and everything. Mr. Williamson, you can't cook in your room. Bullshit. He pulls out his knife and puts it right under the guy's neck. And the guy backs up, he's on the second floor, the guy backs up to the top of the stairs, and Sonny Boy's backing him up and backing him up, and pretty soon he's at the top of the stairs, so Sonny Boy grabs his tie, and the guy leans back, so Sonny Boy chops off his tie, and he rolls down the stairs. So Sonny Boy cooked in his room at the hotel. And then there's a bunch of pulled the knife on Eric Clapton stories too that, you know, that we don't need to pause too long, but that's the one of the Sonny Boy stories.
London. Let's do That's Tough instead. This one's too much like the last one. Is the surf beat one in F?
Good. That's tough.
This one of mine. This, I got a master's degree in college to do junk like this. He's got more college than I do. One, two, three.
Well, now your broken mind is tight. The piece of me is hot. I guess you got something that I ain't got. And that's tough. Your loving is cold and that's tough. Well, when it comes. Not the same way as it was before. Things are gone slow, it don't need you no more. And that's tough. Business is down and that's tough, baby.
Well, when it comes to working,
the times they show got rough. You know what?
Well, that's tough.
A day later, dollar short, but that's tough. We're so sorry about what happened, baby.
Privilege to go down to Mardi Gras one February. And the great thing about Mardi Gras is they break out them old records down there. How about a little Fats Domino, huh? Ernie K. Doe. Wild Chopper to the Neville Brothers. But what I like the best is that piano of Professor Longhair. Just a little bit like this. Like this. B-flat harmonica, I'll tell you that.
It's on a quick plan.
It's the world's most expensive instrument, ladies and gentlemen. Every time you turn around, 50 bucks here, 100 bucks there.
You know, all of my loving and everything. All of my loving and everything. The little girl waited till I got down below zero. Mississippi, she put me out for another man.
The great Sonny Boy Williamson. This is what you call a Texas shuffle, a little bit different beat. Sonny Boy tune for you off the new CD. Some of these I'm doing for the first time other than recording, right? So But this one's it's almost got no words to it. It's just a feeling song, kind of.
That's my favorite one.
Yeah, it came off great, the recording. Phil did quite a number on this one. My recording man here.
That's what I am.
Yeah. Bass player, guitar player, piano, plays piano.
Cup of tea, makes a lovely cup of tea.
Well, you know, I have to say something, and you know, in Seattle, we have legalized weed, you know. And the last recording session I had to do, we got nothing done. I'm prepared. I'm a lightweight, I don't mess around, you know. But my band showed up in a cloud of smoke and we got nothing done. Now, when I went in Phil's studio, would you like a cup of tea? Sure. Would you like another cup? Sure. We must have had 11 cups of tea and we got a lot of work done.
Yeah. And
it was much better than the stoned-ass Seattleites, I'm telling you.
Well, I don't know about you, man, but I ended up with the tea sweats and an anxiety. Four beers, man.
A lot of caffeine.
Yeah. You know, legalized marijuana has its pluses and minuses.
Yeah. It's the almond milk I didn't trust. I'm not with it.
Always look out for me. I've got a right to trust my baby. The little girl always look out for me. Start to be. Every time my baby walks, I can feel the earth shake. My poor heart start to beat. Thank you. right to trust my baby. You know she always look out for me. Always look out for me. Well, now that sweet, you know it's so good to me. Thank you so much. It's great to play for you.
Stop right now.
You gotta stop right now.
Darling.
Mr. Phil Deering on the guitar, Mr. Elliot James Badden, the Fonz on the bass guitar, Mr. Mark Johnson Brown, Mr. Steve Bailey, Washington State Blues Society Hall of Famer. Thank you so much, Sir Richard, for having us here at the Choosing That Music Club. We've got one more for you.
I have to hand it to these guys. You probably don't know, but this is the first time they've heard some of these songs, and these songs are different, you know, a little bit different. That beat and all that, but I really appreciate these guys. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Try, you want to try Stranger Blues?
Yeah. He's by the great Elmore James.
Thank you.
like a trap, so I have a line. Well, I'm going back down south, yes, I am.
Good night, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
We'll see you next time.
You know, it's funny how things come around. I started listening to blues because of the first Stones album, and I was trying to imitate Mick Jagger, and then my best friend goes, come over to my house, Hey, let me play Howlin' Wolf for you. So I got turned on from the English scene to blues, and now we've got blues musicians over here. I'm going to come over here and play. We've got, you know, We've got a whole bunch, a whole army of Stevie Ray Vaughan wannabes over there. And these guys want to play blues, so how about it for these guys? It's really wonderful. Thank you. Thank you so much. I got it down. Thank you.